So welcome to session 6. So in this session we will be discussing about a problem on comparative balance sheet. So in the previous session we briefly discussed about the comparative financial statement analysis, also called as horizontal analysis of financial statement. So the brief steps will be like this. So in three stages, the comparative balance sheet will be prepared. So moonu hantadalli naavu ee comparative balance sheet annu prepare martteve illi. So first step, we have to specify the absolute figures of the assets and liabilities relating to the particular accounting period of the company or with respect to any financial year in column number 1 and 2. So here little modification is required. So in the asset side, first we have to bifurcate current assets, next fixed assets, and similar in the balance sheet also. In the liability side, first current liabilities, then the long term liabilities, then the shareholders equity, where capital reserve, all these things are coming. In the second step, we need to find out the increase or decrease in absolute figures. So absolute change only we have to find out, and in the last step we need to find out the percentage change in assets and liabilities of the current year with respect to the previous year. The formula is here: absolute change divided by the previous year figure multiplied by 100. So when we'll go through the problem, so all these three steps will be explained in detail. So directly we'll go to the illustration. So from the following balance sheet of Mrs. Kapoor and Co. for the year ending December 2019 and 2020, so they given here, we have to prepare the comparative balance sheet of these 2 years. So the problem is given like this: liabilities, equity, share capital they're having, reserves and surplus they're having, debentures 2 lakh and 3 lakh, long term loan they're having 1 lakh and 1,50,000. On the asset side, they're having land and building, plant and machinery, furnitures, and other fixed assets. I think these all are the component of fixed assets. Next, current liabilities. We are having bills payables, sundry creditors, and other current liabilities. On the asset side, we are having current asset item or component of current assets: cash, bills receivables, sundry debtors, stock, prepaid expenses. So now we have to prepare the comparative balance sheet. So solution, I told the solution is divided into three steps. First step, the first two columns. See, the first two columns, as it is, we have to write for the year ending 2019 here and 2020. Next, we need to find out the absolute change, increase or decrease in terms of amount. We need to find out, and in the last column, we need to find out the percentage change. So very simple. So let us explain this solution step by step. As I told, We can't write as it is the given problem or given balance sheet. So we need to rearrange the assets. So first we need to write current assets. So first heading will be current assets. So under the current assets, we are having cash balance. So cash balance in the year 2019, we are having 20,000. In the year, it is 40,000. Andre, 2019ne varshadalli 20,000 nammatra nagadu ittu. Adhe riti 20 20ra konege the balance of cash is 40,000. So absolute change is difference. We need to compare current year minus previous year. So 40,000 minus 20,000 means actually plus 20,000. Additional 20,000 cash is increased. So next, percentage wise we need to calculate how much percentage cash is increased. So formula, if you apply that, absolute change 20,000 divided by or upon the previous year amount 20,000 into 100, so that will give 100%. So like that, you need to calculate for all the items in the balance sheets. So next item is bills receivable. Similarly, 2019 it was 1 lakh. In the year 2020, the amount is 80,000. So if you compare, from 1 lakh it is reduced to 80,000, means 20,000 decreased. So minus 20,000 we have to write. So in terms of percentage, 20,000 upon 1 lakh, if you do that calculation and multiplied by 100, you will get 20% bills receivable is decreased. Next, sundry debtors, 50,000 increased. In terms of percentage, 25% sundry debtors increased. Next, stock, 2,50,000 to 3,50,000, I think 1 lakh is increased. So in terms of percentage, 40% is increased. Next, in the case of prepaid expenses, 2019 nil, but in the 2020, 2,000 additional prepaid expenses are created. So plus 2,000, so 100% prepaid expenses are increased. Now ultimately here, you will get the total current asset. So 2019, it was 5,70,000. In the year 2020, 7,22,000. So nearly 1,52,000 current asset increased, and in terms of percentage, it is increased nearly 26.67%. Next, we will continue with the asset side. Fixed assets. So here all the component of fixed assets will come. So first one is land and building. Same calculation. 2,70,000 ಇತ್ತು 2019 ಇಸವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ 1,70,000 ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಷಿನರಿ ಅಗೇನ್ 2 lakh additional, 2 lakh increased, percentage 50%. Furniture 20,000 to 25,000, 5,000 increased, 25%. So how will get 25%? 5,000 divided by 20,000 into 100. Next, other fixed assets, 5,000 increased, so percentage 20%. And total fixed asset nearly increased by 1,10,000. In terms of percentage, it's nearly 13.5%. So if you see the overall asset, the total asset in the last row, so total asset was nearly 12,85,000 for 2019. 2020, at the end of 2020, the balance is 15,47,000. So 2,62,000 assets was increased in the year 2020. So percentage wise nodidadre naavu 20% asset jaasti agide. So then now same calculation will apply to the liabilities also. Now the liabilities, I told the bifurcation will be like this. First current liabilities, next long term liabilities, and last shareholders fund or owner's equity. So first the current liabilities part, I think the three items are there: bills payable, sundry creditors, and other current liabilities. So dear student, to prepare the comparative balance sheet or to that bifurcate, you need to know the specimen of balance sheet. So as per the recent amendments with the notes and all, it's coming, but very simply we can follow this particular specimen of preparing the comparative balance sheet. So first we go for the current liabilities. So bills payable from 50,000 decreased to 45,000, so minus 5,000. The percentage wise 10% decreased. Sundry creditors 20,000 increased, percentage 20% increased. Next, other current liabilities, if you take from 5,000, it is increased to 10,000, so 5,000 increased, so percentage wise 100% increased, and total current liabilities increased by 20,000, and in terms of percentage it is nearly 12.9%. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಂದಿನ ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಹೋಲಿಸಿದ್ರೆ 2020ರಲ್ಲಿ ಶೇಕಡ 12% ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನಾವು ದ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಡಿಬೆಂಚರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಲೋನ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಂಪೊನೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ 2 lakh ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ಟು 3 lakh. ಸೊ ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ 1 lakh ಡಿಬೆಂಚರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್. 1 lakh upon 2 lakh multiplied by 100, if you do that, it will give you 50%. Long term loan, it's like from 1 lakh it is increased to 1,50,000, so 50% increased. So total long term liabilities increased by 50%. I think it's here. Next we will come over to the last component, that is shareholders fund. So equity share capital from 5 lakh to 7 lakh, so 2 lakh absolute figures, percentage 40%. Reserves and surplus also here decreased by 1,08,000, so nearly 32%, I think nearly 33% of reserves and surplus decreased. So this will work for analysis part later. And total owned equities or owner's equities increased by 50%, and ultimately the capital and the liabilities is increased by 20.39%. So the total assets and total liabilities are same. So this is the format of the comparative balance sheet. So here we compared the position of the same company, Mrs. Kapoor and Co., with respect to two financial years, 2019 and 2020. So at the end we need to give some interpretation. So by observing all these results. So ultimately, as a student, you need to develop that interpretation skill. So result and now discussion madbeku. So for example, here if you compare the position, I think the fixed asset is nearly increased by 13%. If you go back to the table, so here you will come to know that nearly fixed assets are increased by 13%. So it shows that the company's investment is increased and long-term liabilities are increased and equity share capital also increased. So this fact indicates that the policy of the company is to purchase the fixed asset from the long-term source of finance. Next, the current asset also increased by nearly 26.67% and cash also increased by 20,000. But on the other side, current liabilities have increased only by 12.9%. So if you compare the current assets and current liability position, I think the company is having good liquidity position. So the company is having more current assets. And last observation with respect to the reserves and surplus is decreased by nearly 32%, huge percentage decreased. So you can anticipate that the reserves and surplus, the profit, are used to make payment of dividend to the shareholders, either in the form of the like cash or maybe in the form of the stock dividend. It's also called as bonus shares. So ultimately, if you compare, when you compare the position of 2 years, so finally we can conclude that the financial position of the company is satisfactory. So ultimately, you will be able to analyze the company's financial position here for the 2 years and able to interpret the results. Thank you.